If you recall last episode, I mentioned that Type 2 civilizations are able to harness the entire energy output of their star.
In other words, Type 2 civilizations have complete control over their star. There's been a few theories proposed on how that can be done, the most popular one being the Dyson sphere. More on that later.
Welcome to Later. As I was going through the comments on the previous video, I noticed the most common reaction to the episode seemed to be somewhere along the lines of, "Bitch, we gonna die." And you're not wrong. Some do it sooner than others. If you're a little lost on what the hell I'm talking about right now, I'd suggest watching the previous video first and then coming back to this one. A lot of what I'll be talking about today does relate back to the last video, so go watch it. It'll fill in a lot of holes for ya. I understand a lot of you are having a bit of a crisis after realizing how much advanced other species out there are, but no worries. As your local, mostly benevolent extraterrestrial, I'm always here to help. You guys want to become a Type 2, and the best way to do that is by creating a Dyson sphere. And no, I'm not talking about some vacuum. I'm Vibi, and on this episode of A Space Alien Explains, the Dyson sphere. Consider this your step-by-step guide to making your own star energy-grabbing megastructure. Just as easy as baking a cake. First, you gotta preheat the oven to 350.
We're not actually baking a cake, Vibi.
I know. We're baking us a sphere of f*** you. So first thing I wanna clarify is we're not actually building a giant shell encapsulating the whole sun as some people might think. Too many problems with that, and there's just not enough material. What I'm recommending instead is a variation that some call the Dyson Swarm. The Dyson Swarm is literally a swarm of separate solar energy collectors orbiting around the sun. Much easier and more plausible to build than the shell model. No shell, only swarm. So now that we know what type of Dyson sphere we're gonna be making, how do you actually build it? Step one, workers. While you could send humans up into space to construct the pieces for your swarm, it's honestly much too dangerous and expensive. A cheaper and safer option? A horde of bots. Not the Russian kind. Robots are gonna be your lifesaver and money saver here. Make a bunch of them. Lots of them. Put them in space. If one of them gets wrecked, burns up in the sun, gets hit by an asteroid, gets abducted by me, who cares? You have more. Step 2, materials. Now Earth's gonna be all out of raw materials to build the sphere by the time you're finished constructing all the bots needed, so you gotta get more. Unfortunately, one of the planets in your solar system is gonna have to take the hit. If it was up to me, I'd mine Mercury. Humans are always b***ing about it's going wrong, Mercury must be in retrograde. So no one will miss it. And everyone gets to add +5 to the luck stat. Mercury should be enough, but if you want to, you could always mine Venus or a few asteroids too.
Wouldn't disassembling Mercury cause a disruption in the gravitational balance of the solar system?
You're causing a disruption in the balance if nobody asked you. Step 3, putting it all together. Mine your raw materials, construct in space, put those babies in orbit. Of course, the sun energy your swarm collects is going to have to be sent wirelessly. Lasers might be a good option, but if you come up with some other way to send the energy back to Earth, sure. Or maybe, after constructing everything, you decide to abandon Earth and build artificial habitats to float around with the swarm. Kinda like what my planet's starting to do. But Vibi, all of this sounds impossible. And Dyson spheres are totally hypothetical, aren't they? Where's the proof that all this can be done? Well, ladies and gentlemen, and all of our other forms, you might have found a Dyson sphere in your galaxy already. Two, actually. But that's for next episode. If you'd like to see how that bullshit happened next week, be sure to hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you know exactly when the new vid-
A cliffhanger with a plug asking people to subscribe. Lame. Vibi, I thought you were better than this.
Eat my entire ass! Hi everyone, thank you so much for watching and I hope you enjoyed this episode. Rather than showing a featured fan art as usual, I'd like to issue a challenge to any artists out there watching. A couple months back, BR1VerZ on Twitter started the Vibisona tag, and honestly, it's looking a little barren. I thought it would be really special to add more entries to the tag since it's Aliens Month and all that. So go ahead and make yourself into a Vibi or Bellum-inspired alien, tag it as Vibisona, and I'll try to feature as many Vibisonas as I can in the next few episodes. If you want to at me on your Vibisonas to make extra sure I'll see it, I'm totally cool with that too. All my accounts across different sites are linked in the description. Moving along from that, here's some comments from the last video. If you enjoyed this episode, please be sure to drop a like and hit that subscribe button. If you would like to support the channel, I have a Ko-fi page and I'll make you a doodle for any coffees you give. I also take commissions. Info is linked below along with my social media stuff. Again, thank you so much for watching and I'll see you next week.